A Ukrainian MP has told 10 News First that Australia should be doing more to help the country's war effort. Kyiv says it is possible to defeat Russia this year, but only if more lethal weapons start flowing from international allies. And on the eve of the invasion's anniversary, fears are now growing. President Putin is planning to unleash more brutality.
In wartime, no day is guaranteed. Ukrainians plan in weeks, not months, never really knowing when the next attack will come. Tomorrow's anniversary of Russia's invasion brings a painful year sharply into focus, but pain is far from front of mind for these tens of thousands of Putin fans, the president arriving to the Defender of the Fatherland concert to cheers. When we stand together, we have no equals, he says. Russia, 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 they chant back. It has been an extraordinary year, and even those in positions of power admit they didn't think Ukraine would make it to this milestone.
Nobody believed we'll stand for more than 2 or 3 weeks, and we are here.
But that has come at an enormous cost. Memorials to the fallen represent just a tiny number of those who have died. The true death toll from the conflict will never be known.
Ukraine is now moving to the next phase of the war, trying to rebuild and recover, even as brutal attacks continue. President Zelensky hopes 2023 will be the year of victory, but for that to happen, international allies need to dig much deeper, and Kyiv wants Australia to be doing much more.
You have tanks and we need those tanks. You have armory and we need that armory. Help us defend our country.
Some Australians have already answered that call. Evan Solichuk is a plumber turned aid worker.
It's very fulfilling on a personal level, but it's also very sombering just to see how much these people are in need of basic things that we take for granted. It's just a reminder of, you know, how easy life is back in Australia, I guess.
The 32-year-old father felt compelled to help. He delivers van loads of life-saving supplies to soldiers, civilians and children on the front line in Ukraine's east.
Australia.
Medication, first aid kits, food and warm clothing, the basic necessities for people just trying to live.
There is always people that need more aid, and there is always more that we wish we could do. We never have enough.
Without this help, it would be impossible for some families to survive.
And John Paul joins us now from the Ukrainian capital. JP, we are now less than 24 hours away from the anniversary. So what's being done to try to stop this war going another year or perhaps longer?
Well, Sandra, Western allies are banding together with unprecedented unity to stop Vladimir Putin's war of attrition. US President Joe Biden has now wrapped up his trip to this part of Europe, departing Poland after meeting with a group of countries known as the Bucharest Nine. The key talks were held with nations on NATO's eastern flank most at risk from a potential Russian attack. The US President Joe Biden addressed Russia's withdrawal from that nuclear weapons treaty for the first time. He said it is a, quote, big mistake, and that the US would defend every inch of NATO territory. During those remarks, Joe Biden actually had ash on his forehead. That was from a Mass for Ash Wednesday he had with a Polish priest. We're told the two prayed for peace in Ukraine at that service. Joe Biden's visit here to Kyiv a few days ago has really boosted spirits ahead of the anniversary and given people here optimism the US will do much more to help Ukraine win the war. Sandra?
With the latest from the front lines, John Paul, thank you.